Wow, what a beautiful day. Doesn't it just make you wanna...
stay inside and play video games? If so, you're in the right place. Hi, local gacha gaming gambling addict Tectone here. And today, I'm bringing you my own personal top 10 list of upcoming gacha games that you should keep your eye on. So, with that out of the way, hey, just like, comment, subscribe, please. Thanks. So real quick, before I actually get into this video, I just wanted to say that as we get more concrete information about the actual exact release dates of these games, I will make a video and a community post letting y'all know that these games have been released. And the reason why I want to do this is because too often gacha games, especially these days, get delayed straight up out of nowhere. So when they actually do get released, I will let y'all know as soon as possible. So I do encourage y'all to hit subscribe if you do want to know that as soon as possible. I would also like to say that this top 10 list is in no particular order, because what I might like in a game, you guys might not like in a game. So doing that would feel like an injustice. However, if you really want to know my opinion, I will let y'all know at the very end of the video in what exact order I am excited for these from best to worst. But they're all good, right? They're in my top 10 list. They're all going to be great games. But as you can probably tell by the footage behind me, coming in at the number 10 spot is Digimon Re-Arise. And the reason why I'm so excited for this as well, because it's Digimon. And Digimon has been something that's been keeping me comfort since I was a kid. It has one of the strongest IPs out there. And a good IP means that that's going to get traction straight off the bat, because people are literally going to play it because it's Digimon. And having more players, in my opinion, and then, well, a lot of business's opinion as well, makes for a really good game, because it'll have a very lively and healthy fan base. But that's not to mention that this is one of the most alive gacha games that you are going to play. And the reason why that is because it actually has an open overworld where you and your Digimon can interact, and you can feed them snacks, and your buddy's friends can come over and interact with your Digimon. And it's just very playful and it's very fun. And on top of all of the lively effects, the combat system is also extremely high-paced and interactive, which is amazing because everything is happening all the time. It is a very fluid, semi-turn-based type of Digimon game, which is really, really great as far as the combat goes. And the last thing that I really, really, really want to talk about is that it's so tiresome when you play these games and you have a level 32 Fairy King, or whether you have a level 58 Fairy King, it's going to look like the same unit. But in this game, the higher level your units get, well, they Digivolve. And it feels so cool that when you actually go up in level, your units actually look like they're going up in level as well. And it's just, if there's one word to describe this game, it truly is alive. And coming in at the number 9 spot, we actually have the game Delayed McGee. And by that, I mean Sinnoh Alice. Yes, a lot of y'all might have heard of the debacle about this game getting delayed 2 days before release. And yeah, that absolutely broke my heart. However, this game is still being directed by Yoko Taro. And if you know who that name is, then go ahead and grab a tissue from your nearest tissue box and wipe the saliva off your chin, because that man is going to make a damn good game. Yes, this game is actually so good, I actually delved into the Japanese server at length and made more guides than you can even count. Speaking of things that you can't even count up to, the amount of collabs for this game is too damn high. They have things from like Code Geass to Nier Automata and everything in between. It's shaping up to be an absolutely amazing game and is already doing incredible on the Japanese servers. Now, I could go and play it on the Japanese servers. However, I don't speak English. So yes, I would love for this game to come on the global servers. That way I can stop translating every single frame of this game, but it is that good to be worth that amount of work. And my God, the combat for this game is unreal. With 20v20 real-time guild battles, this game's got literally something for everybody, and especially the hottest waifus this side of your local boba tea shop. It's pretty damn nice, I'm not gonna lie, and I cannot wait for this game's global release. Okay, coming at the number 8 spot, we actually have Seven Deadly Sins Hikari to Yami no Grand Cross, probably is how you say it. I don't know, but regardless, this is going to be considered one of the most anticipated gacha games coming out this year. And honestly,
it's kind of hard to disagree with people saying that. I mean, the game is incredibly innovative. This game has like a 4.9 out of 5 review on QApp, and like, that's unheard of for a gacha game, knowing that the RNG of your game can make or break your reviews on any site. So, I mean, those are pretty impressive reviews, but the combat and the IP, and that's kind of a common theme for a lot of the gachas in this list, is just incredibly strong IP. But Seven Deadly Sins, in my opinion, is one of the stronger ones. I mean, it's nothing compared to Digimon, but I mean, my God, this thing is huge on Netflix, and for good reasons. It's a great show. But yeah, Seven Deadly Sins, I cannot wait for this game to come out. I've never seen a combat system like it. It's like a borderline card game, borderline like highly interactive turn-based combat. It's super, super cool, and everything looks super crisp about this game. Coming in at the number 7 spot, we have Exo's Heroes, and I'm gonna be honest with y'all, the art style alone has piqued my interest. Honestly, when your game looks this good, and my God, does it look good? I mean, the waifus in this game, I mean, Jesus, they got some plot to them. Let's just leave it at that. But I mean, my God, I mean, the art alone has got me interested for this game. And yes, this game is coming, I believe, the soonest out of all the titles on this list. So if you're looking for a game where you're trying to find love for the first time, I guess look no further than Exo's Heroes. I mean, I really don't know much about this game, but with how much hype there is behind and how great it looks, I couldn't not put it on this list. Do you like dragons? Because if you don't, go ahead and skip this one, okay? Because coming in at the number 6 spot is called Dragon Sky, Idol and Merge. And I'm not gonna lie, when I was first making this list, I needed one extra. You know what I mean? I needed like that one extra to get that crisp top 10 title. You know what I'm saying? But the more I looked into this game, the more I fell in love with it. It's just like a dragon idol game. It's like Galaga, but with dragons. It's just like, it's such a simple and beautiful concept that, yeah, I wanted to try it. And I've never played a true idol game, but Dragon Sky Idol and Merge will actually be my first. And it's made by Comduos, which kind of makes me innately give them the benefit of the doubt. And I will pretty much play any game they come out with, because in my opinion, they're a pretty good company. So yeah, Dragon Sky Idol and Merge. Dragons, 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 dragons. There you go, that's the game. Coming in at the number 5, so we have Shingeki no Kyojin, aka Attack on Titans Tactics. Now, this game also looks pretty damn slick, but even more importantly, and once again, keeping with the common trend, it is backed by a serious IP. If you like Attack on Titans, this game will definitely be worth you checking out. It looks really, really, really good too, and the gacha system is so exciting. They got like Mikasa going in and slashing all the Titans on their weak point in their little neck, and it just looks real clean. And once again, I'm a big fan of tactic type gachas, so I am extremely excited to play this game, and you should be too. I believe the reviews are going pretty damn good for this game over in the Japan servers as well. Now, this one I severely underestimated. We're talking about Shining Beyond, coming in at the number 4 spot. And oh my God, I looked at this game a couple of months back and I really didn't think too much of it, because I was never really a fan of the use the thumbstick to move and all that jazz. But the more I looked into this game, the more I realized that this is everything that I actually want in a gacha. And I might seem like I'm overhyping this game, but my God, this game looks so good. Like, you can play it alone and get the full experience, or you can bring two of your buddies. And the really cool thing is, you can bring your buddies, but then they can also AFK. So if you want to help out your buddies progress in the game at higher difficulty levels, they can be at work, they can send in their little trooper, put it on auto mode, and then you can carry their ass while they're making the big bucks. That way they can take you out to eat afterwards. It's pretty damn cool. I mean, for real. I mean, this game gets me super excited. I cannot wait to play it, because it is going to be the first gacha of its kind that I'm actually going to experience. Like, generally I just play the turn based, but this game, it's something else. Like, it's like a dungeon crawler hack and slash with your buddies. It's so cool. Really brings me back to the old PS2 days of Gauntlet Legends. But yeah, this one's a serious contender. Okay, I have a confession to make. I have not beat a Final Fantasy game. However, coming in at the number 3 spot, and you bet your ass I'm playing this one, and I'm gonna beat it somehow. I mean, it's gotcha, right? Regardless, Final Fantasy Brave Exuvius War of the Visions, my god, what a mouthful, looks really, really nice. Oh my god, the characters you can collect, the animations in the game, and just the whole tactic type of battling, it's very Fire Emblem-esque. I'm really excited, and more than me, my wife is extremely excited because Final Fantasy Tactics was actually one of, if not her favorite game of all time. So yeah, I'm going to get in there. We're going to get in there. Hopefully, we're all going to get in there, and it's going to be a really great time. And by the way, when I say we all are going to get in there, I use that term very specifically by we all, because this game literally has over 39 million downloads over on the Japan server. Oh my god. I've never heard of numbers that high, but those numbers alone are what is going to definitely make me get in there with everybody else. All right, I'm going to be honest, okay? I could have put this game at number 1, and the list once again is in no particular order, but coming in at number 2 is Rush Wars, okay? Now, this is gonna seem a little bit out of place from my previous list, but I couldn't not put this game on the list because it's a Supercell game. You know what's great about Supercell games? They have the one thing that majority of gachas don't have, and that is infinite longevity. If you get into a Supercell game early, then you will not need to find another game if it dies. Because the thing is, it won't die. The only time you have to stop playing a Supercell game is if you get bored, because this company advertises. Oh my god. I tried it and it's pretty good, I'm not gonna lie, but just getting into a new Supercell title early seems great. And once again, it's very different than your typical gacha, because there's zero grinding. It's all PvP gameplay. You get in, you fight people, you blow stuff up, you get out. It looks like a lot of fun. Now, is it gonna be great? Who knows? But at the end of the day, for the brief period that I played it, I did have a lot of fun with it. But I mean, it's Supercell, right? You gotta put them on here somewhere. Hey, congratulations, you made it all the way to the number 1 spot. And if you have made it this far, please give me a subscribe. Please, they're free. Please give me one. Thanks. Anywho, the number 1 spot going to Yu Yu Hakusho Genkai Battle Spirits. Now, yes, I told you I could not control the order of this list. It's completely random. But if there's one thing that really shows what I'm about in this list, I like anime. And I like a lot of anime. Yeah, there's like, what, 7 anime games? Not even. There's pretty much, they're all anime games besides Rush Wars. But regardless, this game looks, the game looks great. It's backed by another amazing IP. If you haven't seen Yu Yu Hakusho, the anime aged tremendously, like a fine wine, if you will. Go watch it if you haven't already. It's a great watch, and the series goes by very, very, very quickly. Yeah, I mean, it's just your typical gacha hero collector beat 'em up. It's gonna look good. I'm gonna play it because it's Yu Yu Hakusho. Not much else to say. If you like Yu Yu Hakusho, you're gonna play it. If you don't like Yu Yu Hakusho, you're not gonna play it. That's pretty much cut and dry, like the majority of this list. All right, hey. I guess if you're still here, let's get into some personal opinions now.
Well, that was one roller coaster of a list now, wasn't it? Hey, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you don't mind dropping me a comment of what gacha game or what game in general you're looking forward to the most, I'd appreciate it. Yeah, if you probably can't tell, yes, this was my first type of video I've ever made like this. Generally, I go into video games and I deep dive and figure out how to have the best beginner experience and how to play as free to play as possible, which I'm gonna do for every single one of these games. So if you want to check that out, I guess subscribe if you like, or just subscribe just for me if you don't mind. But I understand if y'all thought this video wasn't that good. It really was like a new experience for me. I really did try my hardest on this video. I'm coming up on 7.5 hours of editing post-op. So yeah, I'm really not used to this, but hey, I hope you enjoyed or at least appreciate the hard work that I put into this, and at least can see it for what it is, which is really, this is a love child of a video. I really, really wanted to knock it out of the park with this and just get some more experience underneath my belt. I'm gonna quit ranting. Let's talk about my top 10 list for
what I want to see, the games that I'm most excited about in order. Okay, so if you did actually want to hear in what order I am most excited for these games, at number 10, I would put Rush Wars. At number 9, I would put Yu Yu Hakusho. At number 8, I would probably put Attack on Titan Tactics. At number 7, I would put Sinnoh Alice because I'm too afraid of it actually not being released. At number 6, I would probably put Exos Heroes. At 5, surprisingly, I would actually put Dragon Sky Idol and Merge. At number 4, I would put Digimon Rearise. At number 3, I would do Attack on Titan Tactics. At number 2, I would do Final Fantasy Brave Exuvius War of the Visions. Seriously, what are they thinking with that title? And lastly, yeah, and I definitely wouldn't have said this yesterday, but number 1, Shining Beyond. I'm stoked. I'm not gonna lie. I'm stoked as hell for that game. You know, it looks good, man. It's gonna be such a breath of fresh air. But yeah, hey, I hope you enjoyed the video. I've been Tanktone. Y'all been great. Hope y'all are having a damn good one, and peace!